section. Okay, so we're going to be looking at musical form. Most of this is all going to be based on your final project. And remember, your final project is going to be basically learning a tune by ear and then putting together a document that would be able to be uploaded to YouTube, to Ultimate Guitar. So it would have lyrics on it, it would have probably chords over it for most of us, and it would also have form structure, okay? And if you don't know what form structure is, some of us already know some of these terms that are on the board. That's basically what we're talking about today, which is these sorts of things and how they work with form, okay? So I already wrote up your answer to what form is on the board, but when we're talking about form in a piece of music, basically all we're talking about is the structure that it takes, okay? When we listen to a piece of music, we can hear that certain things happen, some things come back, some things don't come back and they're completely different and then they only happen once, okay? That's what we're talking about when we're talking about structure. But to talk about that structure, we need a few terms to be able to describe that structure. So let's take a look at some of these terms, which some of you guys have probably already heard of, but we're going to talk about them in terms of music and lyrics, okay? So let's have a look at each one of these separately. And the only ones that we're going to look at first is verse and chorus. So can somebody tell me what verse and chorus are? Please be quiet. Come on in, guys. Thank you. Verse and chorus. We've all heard these terms before, yes, in some fashion. So how could we describe what a verse is or what a chorus is? Peter?
A verse doesn't repeat, a chorus repeats.
Very good. And what is it that repeats with a verse? Okay, so the lyrics, we're talking about the lyrics, and when we're talking about lyrics, Nicole, what are we talking about lyrics? What do lyrics mean?
The words
that are being sung, that's all that the lyrics are, okay? So we have lyrics and we have music, okay? Both of those are happening simultaneously in a piece of music, although there are certain sections that might not contain one of these. But in any case, what we're looking at is how these work with each one of them. So Peter is saying that the music doesn't necessarily, or the lyrics don't necessarily repeat, right? Every single time for a verse section. Is that right, what you're talking about? Okay. So in here, we would say different lyrics. And you can write this in the margins. You're probably going to want it eventually. So different lyrics, but is the music the same every time? For verses? Yes? Okay. So same music. I see some people shaking their heads with it. Some people don't want to be on camera, I guess. Different lyrics, same music. Okay? So that's how we're going to define verse. So now how might we define chorus the same type of way? Why? So when we hear a chorus in a piece of music, how could we describe it using talking about lyrics and music?
It has the same lyrics.
Same lyrics every time. Very good. What about the music? Is that same or different?
Same.
Same every time. So we have the same lyrics, same music, every single time that the chorus happens. Okay? Now, we're going to jump down to this other one, which is called bridge. Does anybody know what a bridge might be? Nicole?
Is it like the build up to the chorus?
Good, it could be, although that is a different thing altogether, which is one thing that I neglected to put in the other class when we do that, which is called a pre-chorus, which happens before a chorus and it builds up. And usually we have the same lyrics, same music, same as the chorus every single time, we just have it sounds different than the chorus. But that's a good point that we do have something that builds up to the chorus sometimes, which is called the pre-chorus. But the bridge is actually different.
Is it like the break in a song?
That's right, it's the break in a song or something that happens that is different than what we've heard before. So how can we talk about it in terms of lyrics and music then? For lyrics?
Different
lyrics.
Different music.
And different music. So we have different lyrics, different music when we get to the bridge section. Now let's talk about these little things which happen often in songs as well. Intro. what might be we consider an intro into what's that?
The introduction.
Okay. Can you talk about it in terms of lyrics or music?
Different lyrics.
Okay, yeah, and most of the time we might not even have lyrics, right? Sometimes we might, but most of the time you're not going to have lyrics. So most of the time we just have an instrumental beginning. So that instrumental beginning starts off the piece, it introduces the piece, and then we move into whatever's going to come after it, whether it be a verse or a chorus or so on and so forth. How about an interlude or a solo? How could we describe that?
No lyrics.
That's right. No lyrics. And it could be either the same or different music. So they could use like the chords or the basic structure of a chorus or a verse and then just have instruments playing over it. Okay, so most of the time you're not going to have lyrics in a section like this one. And what does solo mean? We're talking about a solo.
By itself.
An instrument by itself that is playing usually over the top of a band. Sometimes it's improvised, right? So somebody's coming up with a solo on the spot or an improvised solo on the spot in the middle of the tune usually, but it could be happening anywhere. And what would we consider an outro? Instrumental ending or just an ending. Because a lot of the times what happens is bands like to repeat the chorus over and over again at the end. And that would still be considered an outro because it's still an ending part of the song, okay? So we have some sort of ending that happens that is different than any of the sections that we've looked at before, okay? All right, so with all of these different things that we've looked at, and including this little thing that's called the pre-chorus, because that does happen and may happen in pieces that you guys look at. We are going to listen to a piece of music and see if we can describe that piece of music using all of these. So what you have in front of you, you guys just wrote all those terms in the margin so that you can sort of keep track of that. But what you have in front of you is a page that has little boxes around it, and you're going to see each one of the sections has a portion of the lyrics in it, so you can't feel the heat is the first box. So what I'm looking for this one, as we listen through it, you're going to be listening to the lyrics and the music, and you're going to try to figure out what part we're in, okay? So for the form description, you're going to write verse, or chorus, or bridge, if you think it's a bridge, or interlude if you think it's an interlude, but most of these boxes have lyrics in it, so you're probably going to assume that that's not the case with those ones. What I would like you also to do as you're doing that is if you hear something that's not on this for boxes, like if you hear an intro at the beginning, you can put that before the first box, okay? Just to indicate that you heard that and you know that something happened in there. But we're looking to try to figure out what the structure of this song is, okay? So this is Satellite by Rise Against. We're going to listen to the whole thing, and I want you to try to fill out what each one of the sections are. Now, one thing that we didn't cover, let's say that there are multiple verses. How are we going to indicate the difference between one verse and another?
Verse 1, verse 2.
Verse 1, verse 2. Okay, so just put a number next to each one of them that are different, okay? All right, so here we go. Satellites Rise Against. Listen all the way through it and fill out your forms, and we're going to talk about the form after.
You can't feel the heat until you hold your hand over the flame. You have to cross the line just to remember where it lays. You won't know your worth now, son, until you take a hit. And you won't find the beat until you lose yourself in it. That's why we want.
Yeah.
barely sleep and sail off in the night. We'll come clean and start over the rest of our lives. When we're gone, we'll stay gone, out of sight, out of mind. It's not too late. We have the rest of our lives. We'll sneak out while they sleep and sail off in the night. We'll come clean and start over the rest of
which each what each one of these stanzas were, what you guys came up with for each one of these stanzas. First one, you can't feel the heat. Now, what'd you put?
Verse.
That's right. Did you have anything before the verse?
No.
Okay. Anybody have something before the verse? Intro.
Oh, intro.
Okay. So we did have an intro. It just didn't have a box for it. Okay.
Oh, okay.
So intro, then verse one. Then that's why we won't back down. What'd you get there, Michaela? Course, that's right, because that happens over and over again as we see those lyrics come back. Okay, so we have chorus, then you can't fill your cup, John. That's right. Now, if we already had one verse, what are we gonna have to call it, John? That's right. Very good, Anthony. Griff, that's why we won't back down.
Chorus
again. Now we get tricky. Mason, she told me that she never could face the world again.
That was some pre-bridge thing.
Oh, okay. Interesting. Why would you call it a pre-bridge?
Because it didn't sound like the next one sounded like the bridge, but I don't know what to call that one.
Good. Okay. So we can put a question mark there. We heard, though, that it was different music and different lyrics, okay? So we could call it a bridge if it has different music and different lyrics. We'll sneak out. What are we going to call that one, Emily? Did that sound like anything that we had heard before? Okay, it didn't. So, different music, different lyrics, we'd have to call that again a bridge. So this is a weird thing that Rise Against did, is they ended up with two bridges, okay? Sometimes these things happen, right? They just decided to change it up twice in the middle of the song. So we have bridge, we would call that bridge one, bridge two. Okay, that's probably the best way to describe that one. Because they won't back down, Michaela, where'd we go after that? Chorus, very good. So we come out of bridge two into the chorus, and then, no, we won't back down now.
Okay, I have a question. So chorus is the same lyrics and music, but it didn't have different music. So
good. What was different about the music?
It had different.
That's right. Just drums and just voice. Very good job indicating that. So when we're talking about what the music is, that doesn't necessarily mean what the instruments are doing, right? That usually means what the melody is and how that is working with the lyrics, okay? Did you notice, though, that it was the same exact melody?
Yeah.
That he was singing. Yes, so it's the same melody. The chords were gone at that point because there was no guitar. So it sounded different, but because it had the same melody, we'd still call it a chorus and the same lyrics. Yeah. Good question, though. All right, good. We're going to pack up today, but here's what I would like you guys to do. I may or may not have a little video to look at how to count measures as well for you guys to take a look at tomorrow. But basically what I'd like is the back side. You choose your own tune, and you do this same sort of thing where you write out a few lyrics and then put it in the semblance of a form. Okay? Question now.
Okay.